I feel like there's that basic thrill of seeing something you haven't seen before.
You want to see something cool?
Kind of big screen, wish fulfillment, visual spectacle, but paired with feeling.
Hey.
Hi.
That's the full package of a movie.
The movies that we grew up watching, they all had this element of wish fulfillment. They had this wonderful element of action and adventure. They are still filtered through the prism of my own nostalgia. So, like, the opportunity to actually make a movie like that, I think for both of us, it's so personal.
You're me.
And to come across this script with this super juicy idea, what if you could go back and meet your 12-year-old self?
This is amazing.
Isn't it, though?
A time travel movie that was less about saving the world and more about saving yourself.
Hey, guys!
I remember these little turd burpers.
It's one thing to go back and say to that little kid, hey, it's all gonna be okay. But now, imagine if somebody is deeply self-loathing.
I had no intention of coming back to revisit this.
And one step further, what if you could go back and interact with your parents at the same age as them?
To explore that and with this action adventure time travel element was really unique and special.
So by being here, you may have just changed my whole future?
Honestly, your future is pretty tragic either way.
I'm kidding.
Seeing Walker and Ryan together, their chemistry is off the charts.
The premise of the movie is Ryan Reynolds goes back and meets his younger self. If you don't find that younger self, you have no movie.
It was not only a physical similarity we were looking for, but that ability to be sort of verbal and funny in a way that you believe this young person could grow up to be Ryan Reynolds.
So when does all this happen, and does everyone skip leg day in the future?
I saw hundreds of kids. Walker was incredibly talented. He had this extra superpower.
We need to go.
No, you need to go. This is my fixed time. You already had my childhood.
He had seen Deadpool 30 times. So he has an innate sense of how to channel Ryan back to Ryan.
Ryan, you didn't say lightsaber, but it's not a lightsaber.
We're the same person, so every time I didn't know how to say a line, like just ask him and he'd tell me how he would say it. And so I could just say it like him.
Anyone ever tell you talk too much?
All the time.
Let's come up.
Adam Project is my 13th movie as a filmmaker, but it gave me a chance to bring to life visuals that I haven't done or seen. I want a certain visual spectacle in terms of action, but also in terms of setting.
With time, I've learned to create sets that will be not only like playgrounds for stunts, but playgrounds for special effects.
We're gonna replace a huge amount of what's actually here with a virtual digital set that we will create in post-production. Early in prep, I told the VFX team, I need some kind of program that allows me to see the virtual set on a screen.
So we've got this new technology that we're working on, which Sean calls the Magic iPad. And it's really like a virtual viewer that can show you using the iPad what the whole of the set will look like.
It allows me to explore the set, and it's really opened up shot design possibilities in a real way and from angles that I can't even get to.
So this is it.
This is it.
I'm reliant on an army of artists who all need to bring their instincts, their expertise.
You know this bag of toys you love so much?
Yeah.
Being a geek is about to pay off.
A big thing on this show was Sorian technology. There's a certain design language or pattern within everything that Sorian designs. In the flight bag, young Adam pulls out the mag cell.
And I think it stands for like magnetic cylinder. I don't know. It's called a mag cell. Look it up. You can't because it's not real. I found this small design firm in Australia called Super Vixen. The world hasn't heard of them yet, but all the better to get fresh ideas. They designed the weaponry, the spacecraft, and it gave kind of a fresh new aesthetic to time travel tropes that might feel familiar, but we haven't seen them look the way they look in the Adam Project.
A lot of these 3D models will be handled by VisFX and post, like the center core for the computer at Sorian Labs.
Screw it.
Oh. Oh.
There's probably 200 plus pieces that had to be 3D printed and assembled. VisFX will now be able to take all 200 of those pieces and fly them around the room, and then they won't have to make things up. There's just daily communication with every department. Stunts become really important when they get on board and start rehearsing.
Grab, turn, low.
Gotcha.
The challenge is always where to draw the line. How much do we do practically? How much do they do digitally? Typically, I like to push the line as far as we can. I think you get some of the best action when you have a nice marriage of the two disciplines.
This is months of preparations. We've got futuristic weaponry. We have martial arts. We have fight choreography. We've got vehicles being T-boned.
These actors are able to do a lot of these stunts themselves, which obviously is better when you can actually see the faces of the actors doing it.
Superhero landing.
Ryan is a very physical actor. He's obviously done a lot of action movies. So as much as possible, we are choreographing pieces in longer sections where the real actors are doing the real stunts, the real martial arts, so that the audience understands they're seeing something authentic. Adam Project is an adventure that is, at its heart, deeply emotional.
Well, I'm not going to explain my plan to a 12-year-old nerd with an
inhaler
because I do not
have
a plan that is correct. But I know somebody who might.
Dad.
We're gonna find Dad.
I have not done a lot of movies that really reflected my own personal life the way Adam Project does. Our past is complicated. I find that we tell ourselves stories. I have stories, Ryan, and I have stories that I tell myself about my father that sort of helped make sense of my own deficiencies or my own shortcomings. But at some point in your life, and you look back and you think, wait, are those true? Or are they stories that I've sort of embellished or created to make my own life make sense now? And I think it's really interesting in this film that Adam gets to go back and see his dad, not only when he was alive, but his age. We get to look at each other as peers for a moment, not father-son.
And so this idea of re-meeting your own history, but with the empathy of your current self, the understanding of your current self, that's rich. To do that with time travel and badass action, and a lot of freaking laughs.
I can't believe you're here.
I mean, it's a very moving story.
You're gonna be okay.
It just feels like an embarrassment of riches.
You're gonna be better than okay.
You don't know that.
Are you kidding me? Have you seen this guy?